today, if you are a son of God, if you are a disciple of Jesus, you too are the people of God. And you have an enemy, the devil. And he comes against you because you are God's inheritance. We read, remember what the Amalekites did to you along the way when you came out of Egypt. The people of God, the Jewish nation, they became the Jewish nation. They came out of Egypt. God was sending them to the promised land. And immediately the enemy came, and they were the Amalekites, to keep them from moving further in their journey, to prevent you from growing, to prevent you from entering into your inheritance, to prevent you from receiving all that the Lord has for you, to stop your destiny in the Lord. That great rest that the Lord is bringing you into. When you were weary and worn out, they met you, the Amalekites. When you become disheartened, or when you get a bad report, or when you see bad things happening all around you, you can get worn out. And you can become weary. And when you are like that, you are very vulnerable. And the enemy wants to come in at that time to attack you. When you were weary and worn out, they met you on your journey and attacked all who were lagging behind. But the point here is, that if you get weary, and if you get worn out, and if you get a ho-hum attitude, or a passive attitude, or a lazy attitude, you can lag behind. And we cannot afford, beloved, to lag behind. And the devil walks around like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. He can't devour everybody, beloved. But he's looking for believers whom he can devour, because he wants to stop you on your spiritual journey. He doesn't want you to progress. He wants to destroy your destiny in the Lord. And if you are not in fellowship, not in a very close proximity with other believers, which is paramount in the times that we're living in, you can fall short of the grace of God. We are not to forsake the assembling of ourselves together, as some have, beloved, particularly since the day of the Lord is approaching. Now of all times, you need to find a body of Christ. And if you're serious and you seek the Lord and you ask the Holy Spirit to lead you, He will put you in a fellowship of believers who will help you grow. Learn how to submit to your spiritual leadership. Hear the Word of God. Find somebody, a house of God, that does not compromise the Word and that loves apostolic doctrine, hears the Word, and obeys the Word. Find a place where you can be corrected and directed by the Spirit of the Lord. It's so very, very powerful. And be right in the midst of things. Thank you.